I use these keyboard shortcuts every time I open Adobe Premiere Pro. They allow me to make the most of the space on my screen and are the best way to edit with multiple monitors. My name is Chris, and I'm a filmmaker. So when you're editing, it's best to be able to focus on the project at hand and have nothing else to distract you. So these tips actually work in both Premiere Pro and After Effects. The first step to maximizing your on-screen space is to maximize your window. But you already knew that, right? To get a little more space, press Control Backslash. Pressing Control Backslash removes the title bar and gives you just a few more pixels of height. Now I have dual monitors, so in order to make the best use of the space on both screens, I tear some panels off the main window and drag them over to my second screen. Unfortunately, there's no way to easily maximize these, but if you press Control Backslash, it'll basically do the same thing. And if you press Control Backslash a second time, it will take those floating windows and make them full screen. So now I have Premiere Pro or After Effects on both screens taking up every single available pixel. Every time you open Premiere Pro or After Effects, the main window will remember whether or not you have the title bar visible. However, for the floating windows over on your second monitor, you're going to have to press Control Backslash twice every time you open the program to get them to return to full screen. So now that you've taken Premiere Pro or After Effects and filled the screen as much as possible, there might be still a part of the window that you want to focus on for a time. Maybe you want to expand the timeline so you can see more of it at once while you're doing a particular edit. And you don't really need to see the other panels on your screen. To do this, press the grave accent key. This will take the panel that the mouse is currently over and make it fill the entire window. To get back to the previous view, simply press Grave Accent again. The other way is with Shift and the Grave Accent key. This will fill the window with the currently active panel, the one with the colored border around it. And to return to the previous view, simply press it again. Another thing you might want to do is take the active video and have that fill the screen while you're playing it back so that you can see what's going on in better detail. I could go to the Edit menu, choose Playback Preferences, and enable Mercury Transmit for a specific monitor. But this would enable full screen playback all of the time for that specific monitor. And it's a lot of work to turn it on and off. But if you don't want to commit to having your video full screen on a monitor 100% of the time, press Control and the Grave Accent key. Pressing Control with the Grave Accent key takes the entire video and makes it full screen. So if the source monitor is active, it will make that video full screen. Otherwise, it will make the program monitor full screen, even if that monitor is not active. And to simply exit that full screen, you can press Control and Grave Accent again, or you can press the Escape key. Some of these keyboard shortcuts may not work with non-English keyboards, and while these shortcuts are intended for Premiere Pro and After Effects, they may work partially in some of the other Creative Cloud applications. So I hope these tips have helped you become a more effective and efficient editor. If you want more filmmaking tips, check out my playlist here, and I'll see you next week when I show you how I changed my camera settings to make my camera work better in some very wet weather.